We're in the paddock at John Waugh's place. I've got Neil Wiens with me from Canada. Neil has got a new nutrition product. We're working with Warringah, having a look at it. We've got a trial going down in the background. Neil, tell us a little bit about it. The product, I think, is called Replenish. You've been putting it out in Canada for a while. What is it?
Well, what it is a sustainable, a sustainable alternative phosphorus is more what it is. It's mixed with sulfur and a little bit of compost.
So it is, can we tell people what it's a blend of?
Yeah, so basically what I've done is, maybe what I'll do is I'll back up a couple seconds here, is if you know how MAP is made, I think that's probably the best way to go about this, is MAP is made when you take rock phosphate out of a mine. Mined, and whether it's in Morocco, whether it's in Florida, whether it's Northern Ontario in Canada, it's one of these products that you have to mine this product out. It goes to a $1 billion facility to get the voodoo done to it. But what happens in that voodoo system is they bring elemental sulfur and they burn that elemental sulfur to make sulfuric acid. And then they wash that rock with that sulfuric acid to make the phosphoric acid. And then they add, of course, the ammonia and the acid-base side of it all, and it ends up being MAP.
And that's the process that makes rock phosphate available or soluble.
Exactly, exactly. So what we found over my years of being in basically producing sulfur and compost type products, I've always been into elemental sulfur. So what we did find is a continual spike in the fields that we put on elemental sulfur with compost, my Biosol product back in Canada, I guess I want to call it. We always found a spike in P. And so the whole reasoning behind that is because when the microbial side of that happens to change the elemental sulfur over to a sulfate form, there's always a burst of sulfuric acid in the process. And that is a microbial sulfuric acid, not a chemical sulfuric acid. So when that happens, is any P that was in the soil, or in this case, my little rock phosphate that I put beside it in Replenish, all becomes a product that becomes more available and acts more like a MAP. So what I've done is, instead of having a $1 billion chemical fertilizer plant creating a salt index, we've actually gone and done a bazillion little microbial biology MAP plants, better lack of term.
So the product ends up being a combination of rock phosphate, elemental sulfur, some compost, and some secret sauce.
And some secret sauce.
And then together you end up with a product which is 17P and how much S roughly?
There's about 12 to 15% S.
Yeah.
Yep. So, and then you have a little bit of the, you know, a little bit of the micros that come out of, you know, the rock. So what's really interesting about this product is the same product that we would use, you know, it's the same exact same rock that they use in the MAP system. So, but instead, when they, instead of doing a complete wash and only get the phosphoric acid, we get to keep all the cool minerals that comes along with it. So your micros, whether it's your irons, your manganeses, your nickels, your zincs, so the whole gamut of herbs and spices sticks around with that rock, because every rock has that. So it's kind of neat.
So what you're saying is when you apply it, in each particle, you get the sulfate, elemental sulfur, forms a little bit of sulfuric acid.
Yep.
That interacts with the rock phosphate just in these small halos, I think you call them, to turn the rock phosphate into available phosphate. And then the bugs in the soil convert the elemental sulfur into sulfur.
Yep. Yeah. So that's really the whole... I mean, I wish it was any tougher than that, but it's not. And, you know, I guess that's why we start with the mantra of keep it simple sulfur or keep it simple phosphate or whatever you want to do. It's a total KISS theory.
So how much of it's going on in Canada?
Well, right now we just started the actual rock phosphate portion of it all. The Biosol portion, we're on to 1 million acres a year now in Western Canada. So that's where really a lot of this thought process came out of. The rock phosphate wise, right now we're just getting started, really only been a year into it. So we're about, you know, we're probably about, I apologize folks, I'm into the acre side of it all. So in my case, we're into about 25 to 50,000 acres now of this actual phosphate product.
Yeah, righto. And in Australia though, we're more focused on the phosphate one.
Yes, you are.
Yeah, cool. Excellent. Yeah, good on you, Neil. It sounds interesting. I mean, when we hear about these new things, honestly, it sounds like snake oil, doesn't it? So what we're doing here, we're putting in some trials. We want to prove it to ourselves. John Wall from Warringah wants to prove it himself before he starts selling it to farmers. So putting in some trials around the Northern Wheatbelt of WA this year. I'm a bit involved in helping Wari with the trials, and you're involved, and we'll have a look and see if we've got a new product for Australia.
I sure hope so.
Yeah, thanks, mate.
Right on. Hey, thank you.